الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون وقال تعالى الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لامرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته إلى دنيا يصيبها أو إلى امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. So inshallah, today I'm going to teach it will be an introduction of Imam al-Shatibi's great work Al-Muwafaqat. So this book, when I was in the ulama as a student, I read once under the in instruction and guardianship of one of my teacher, and then again I read many of these of the discussion in this book. Once I was teaching a course on maqasid, and the third time actually I read many parts again when I'm going to teach for this course. Though in meanwhile sometime I have been referring here and there. So every time I read this work, no doubt really, I learn so much. This is really, no doubt, one of the great work of Islam. The few things which have been written, with it properly and full effort. This is one of those top works. Imam Shatibi's book Al-Muwafaqat in our time, actually last century, became very, very famous, very well known. And so much has been written about Al-Muwafaqat and Fiqh al-Maqasid. But when you read the book, you can see most of the things what is said about Muwafaqat actually nothing to do with Muwafaqat. People have picked his certain words and they're using them, it suits them. But it's not what he says. So if you look properly from the end, from beginning to the end, the book is completely different, completely opposite of what people have been saying. So that why, in this course today, I'm not going to refute Fiqh al-Maqasid, because that I've done anyway. I will just teach you what the book is. You can see yourself and then go home and read properly. You can see what this man is teaching. So this is the one thing. Just, the book is there. It is printed. So you can go yourself and read. So don't trust in, don't rely on me or on anybody else. Just see what Imam Shatibi himself said. He wrote this book in a time of decline. In Spain, Muslim, no doubt Muslim Islamic civilization in Spain was very great. But when Imam Shatibi was there, that is the time of decline. And the last kingdom which was left in Spain was the kingdom of Granada, Girnata. Before that, the whole Spain, part of France, and what is it, Portugal, Muslims used to rule all this, very powerful, empires there for a long, long period, around, 600-700 years, maybe more than that. Shatibi's time is very time of decline, when you can see Muslims are weak, and Maliki fiqh has become very rigid. And Maliki jurists are very, very lucky. You can see, if you want to understand this thing, if you go to India, for example, you can see how Hanafi madhab is in some madrasa, so rigid. The same thing was Maliki madhab, so much rigid. And people are using, juziyat, particular things of the madhab to justify many, many things. To somebody rich and they want to find a solution for him, they will find for him those examples of the later fuqa and the help. So all the time this going on, basically helping the people with, like in our time, we want to find any solution for in any problem in finance or anything like that. So we can find examples from the later fuqaha and solve the problem. Shatibi could see that this way basically going to demolish whole Sharia, because what people are justifying it goes against the spirit of the religion. It's exactly the same thing what Jews have been doing, at their decline. When Isa Islam came, the Jews basically all focused on the minor issues and they want to justify every single thing. They disconnected the whole religion from its spirit. So when the religion becomes just form, and the spirit is not there, it is a very, very difficult time. Then Shatibi, really think, and inshallah I'll quote him properly, just give background what he's doing. So he realized that this thing is going to demolish the whole Islamic society. So he is, start thinking how to rebuild again. So he wants to connect the people with the real religion, basically why Islam came, what the purpose is, the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the piety, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you follow any ruling of a faqih, think really how it helps you in your ibadah, think how it makes you more pious. think actually how it helps you in all those things. So he always he's keen to connect every minor issue with its major root, how it is connected. He wants to connect that. So if it actually do you achieve anything or not. So this book was really written for very, very big purpose. And in our time, it really very useful. But again, you know, when people decline, what happens is, so instead of to raise themselves to the level, high level, you know, like, you know, in our time, what we do, instead of we can raise ourselves to the level of the Quran, we actually lower the Quran to our own level. Instead of, to raise ourselves to the level of al-Muwafaqat, what we're doing is, we're actually lowering Muwafaqat to our level. We want to Muwafaqat to justify every single thing, though it is not there. So, you know, this thing, inshallah, you will see with the examples and discussion that I have selected from al-Muwafaqat, every single chapter. So you can see it is not, and actually I want to think, can I summarize this book? So I realized this book never can be summarized. No, there is no single thing in the book that you can feel to leave it out. And one thing about also shocked because I have been teaching now Ar-Risal Imam Shafi, so much similarity. What Imam Shafi has done more eloquently in the language of the early people, you know, Shatibi, they say same thing, but more using, you know, philosophical terminology, exactly same thing. Meaning is, Shatibi is a book you can see, they are like extension of Ar-Risala, but it is so much different from what Ghazali, Imam al-Haramain, Imam Ahmadi, these people have been developing as the name of Usul-Fiqh. Actually, he refutes them anyway. So it is so much different from them. It is really very, very much, sometimes the same wordings, exactly same thing. What Imam Shafi said, same thing is what Imam Shatibi said. Both are very, very similar to each other in this matter. So this, inshallah, also can see. And also I was shocked, really, many, many ideas with Waliullah Dehlavi, you know, is actually known in India. Many of them, certainly, they are very much from in al-Muwafaqat. I don't really think that Waliullah Dehlavi had borrowed from him. I don't know if he knew al-Muwafaqat or not. If he knew al-Muwafaqat, certainly he must have benefited. If he did not know, so it could be that, you know, two great minds, they say the same thing. It sometimes can happen. So there are so much similarity also between Waliullah Dehlavi and between Imam Shatibi. And also, you know, I was reading the discussion in Muwafaqat about al-Qur'an, when he writes about Qur'an. It is so much similarity between him and between Mawla Farahi. So I was thinking, because we are so much amazed by Mawla Farahi. But I don't really believe, I don't realize, don't think Mawla Farahi ever has read al-Muwafaqat. It again could be same thinking, but, you know, he never refers to al-Muwafaqat. He read Ibn Taymiyyah, he knows Ibn Taymiyyah, he knows Ibn Qayyim, but he never mentioned Shatibi. I don't think he ever knew Shatibi. Otherwise, it would have actually much, much more improvement, because Shatibi, you know, one thing about Mawla Farahi is not so eloquent writing, maybe eloquent in thinking, but not writing, because, you know, Arabic is not his language. But when same points are discussed and written by Ibn Qayyim or Ibn Taymiyyah or like Imam Shatibi, it is more eloquent, nicely, so you can see. That's why one of the barriers between Mawla Farahi and Arab people is that people cannot, you know, read his language. It is so different, you know, so it takes a lot of effort. But anyway, so that, alhamdulillah, one thing good actually I realize that, you know, how the scars are similar to each other. Maybe they benefit from each other, but also they are so much similar to each other. And also their approach to the Greek logic and philosophy. You see, Ibn Taymiyyah and then Shatibi, then, you know, Mawla Farahi, all these people, they are expert of Greek logic. Mawla Farahi knows Greek logic and philosophy. Shatibi is so much expert of that, and Ibn Taymiyyah. But all of them, you know, they understand the limits of Greek logic and philosophy, and they also understand the problems of that. Then this also find, you know, so much similarity between all these people. So inshallah, some of those examples will come throughout the day. Before I start, I will just like to discuss a few things to which are very key things in understanding Imam Shatibi. You will be thinking, really, first thing I should introduce is maqasid. That is what people know. But I don't really think that's so important. That one thing you have to know in Shatibi's work is kulliyat and juziyat. That actually all the time keeps coming. So first understand what kulli and juzi is. But before that, one has to know what kul and juzi is. So al-kul means whole, and juzi means part. That actually, you know, like it's just an Arabic word. You know, if you translate in English, it is same meaning. So what means whole in English, same is a kul, and what means part in English, same thing as juzi. So there's no difference. So I wrote in Arabic, because, you know, that I'm going to use, but there's no difference between al-kul and whole, and between al-juz and part. This is how Allah has made the things, and that's how people follow. Like I'm a human being, whole human being. So this is al-kul. But then, you know, my eyes, my ears, my hands, my feet, they are my parts. So every whole contains parts. So that, you know, this is Allah's creation. So you can see, like animals, they have whole animal and parts of animal. So parts are different from parts. So when you say like the cow, you mean the whole thing. But you can't say for the leg of the cow, cow. You can't say for the eye of the cow, as a cow. You don't say like that. You don't apply the name of the whole to the parts, because parts are parts. So this thing people always know. People always have been knowing the whole thing and the part thing. When Greek logic came, philosophy came, they introduced another way, another thing, you know, more scientific concept, philosophical. We are not against that. And if it can help people, there is no problem in that. And al-Shatibi is one of the person who used this a lot. And that's the concept of al-kulli and al-juz'i. So al-kulli and juz'i, kulli is not whole, and juz'i is not part. It is more actually, you can say more, you know, a term of the philosophy. So what they mean by kulli and juz'i, we have to understand this thing. So you can see in this world, you know, things are, you can see so many things. And if you can put all those things in some categories, you can categorize every single thing. So like for example, we are here, you know, all in like in Zaid, Muhammad, Amr, Bakr, Khalid, Fatima, what all these people. If you want to put them in one single category, you say insan, human being. The insan, human being, it basically a major category which includes all these people. If you want to put a human being and horses, donkeys and monkeys and, you know, dogs and cats and all those things, you know, in a major category, so you say hayawan, animal. So hayawan is, you know, big family, and then after that, within that family, there are so many things. There are human being, there are this and this, so many different million types of animals. They all fit in the category of hayawan. So hayawan means animal or living thing. Is a hayawan a kul? Horse is a kul, and then legs of the horse and eye of the horse is its part. Human being is a kul, whole, and you can see my eye is part of me. But when I make a concept, hayawan, and I say for, you know, hayawan is, you know, hayawan are these things. Horses, animals, horses, human beings, and cows and sheep, they are human, hayawan. So what happening here is, can you see the difference? But when I say I am whole, and my, what is relation between me and my eye? Keep in mind. And then think relation between horse and between...